focus on the industry, but into the micro world vertical of that industry, we want to really to reach at some point that you can take a software from us and implement it just by default. Okay? So we are of course not there, but this is really our goal to get there. Okay? You take the software, it has the right integrations, the right content, the right reports that you can run from the beginning. Okay? So very ambitious, but we want to do that because I think it's a big differentiator. It's disruptive because nobody's doing that, but it's very differentiating in the software world. Like the user experience we talked about, for a corporation taking software and implementing it fast, that's really one of the things that we're struggling so far and we're trying to solve it. So this is the industry that Kevin talked about. And I was talking in the beginning, again, a lot of people say, yeah, we have one ERP that does all these industries. But believe me, it's very, very hard to architect that and to maintain that and to create even new versions of it. Because if you touch something, some algorithm, or some special code that you have that you will improve automotive, but you may impact another industry. So every time the decision-making or changing code or introducing new functionality, that decision-making process is very, very long, and it takes even longer. Okay? The other things that next to our core engines, we have best-in-class extended applications. Those are, let me go through that. Those are, like human capital management, enterprise asset management, our SCM, supply chain management, and PLM, best in class. So next to the core engines, you can complement the business process with these applications. Now, one example that I want to show you today is the partnership that we have done, we recently announced with Salesforce.com. That's one of the business processes that we are integrating with our core engines, with our ERPs. Imagine today where you go, when a salesperson go to a customer or just want to see the customer profile of the customer activities, you may have, for instance, some of the data on a CRM system and some of the data on the ERP. A lot of people say, I want to have just one, all the data in one system. And by the way, in the system where I'm more familiar as a salesperson, which is more the CRM actually than the ERP. Okay? So we have integrated, actually, we have built through IAM an integration with Salesforce.com where all the data that you want to configure is actually available in Salesforce.com. So you log in and you could see opportunity leads, sales orders. So the whole life cycle of the customer is in there. Okay? So you manage the customer through a Salesforce.com user interface, but with your ERP data, all integrated. So how it works, very simple. You know that Salesforce runs out of the cloud, okay? So it's not an on-premise application. But your ERP today may run or is running, of course, on-premise. So we have built in IAM a cloud adapter that allows you to integrate your on-premise ERP to the Salesforce.com cloud. And this, by the way, is bi-directional. Okay? So you can decide which data you have leading in Salesforce.com. So you can just decide, in Salesforce.com I do only leads, and then I continue in the ERP. Or I can do I do leads opportunities, and then I go to ERP, I do until quotations, then I go to ERP up to the whole sales orders, and then I synchronize even that to ERP. So you order reverse. Okay? So you really, in IAM, you can really manage the business process and see who's the master and who's the copy. So that's a very, very, very powerful. You're very, very flexible in the setup. The data goes through our cloud, and we have a connector, native connector with Salesforce.com that will ensure the data synchronization. Not only the cloud connector is available, but on the Salesforce.com platform called Force.com, we have built a native applications because the Salesforce.com didn't have these tabs like sales orders and all the others. So we made an applications complementing the standard one so that you have, if you start to synchronize data, you will have all the data available also on the Salesforce.com user interface. So I have a video to start to show you how the integration works. So again, focus on the video. So this is Salesforce.com, very standard. And you see on top, actually, those are the tabs that we have added to the Force.com applications or sales order products, shipments. Those are not really typical Salesforce.com data, but we have added that applications. And when you browse through this data, this actually data coming from ERP LM today, but we have available with other ERPs. Just to give you an idea, now a salesperson doesn't need to go personally to the ERP and figure out all the data. It's all there in one place, in a familiar place where they can work from. So it's all integrated. We take care of the data integrity, the mapping, all of that, it's all taken care of. Okay? So you see this is, and we're working on it to fill even more data. But this is really a good example, not only a technical integration, but a real full functional business process oriented integration. And by the way, all the data that is exchanged, we put it again in the vault so that we can use for in-context BI. So that's also an advantage. It doesn't matter if it comes from the ERP or from Salesforce. You have that 2006, I was 30 kilos more. Now I'm 75, so smaller. I thought, you know, if you're working with iron, you need to lose weight. It's good for your health.
Once
it's connected, then you're going to start to see all kind of use cases that we do with iron, and we will go through that.